Hey there, joint warriors. Ready to uncover the undercover agents wreaking havoc in your arthritis battle? Today, we're about to unveil the villains hiding in your kitchen that could be making your arthritis woes worse. Arthritis, a term that describes various conditions affecting the joints. Symptoms often include joint pain, stiffness, redness, warmth, swelling, and limited mobility in the affected joints. Arthritis can also extend its impact to other parts of the body. It's fascinating to note that there are over 100 types of arthritis, with osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis being the most prevalent. Osteoarthritis is often associated with aging and the wear and tear of joints due to everyday use. On the other hand, rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disorder where the body's immune system mistakenly attacks the lining of the joints, leading to inflammation and swelling. Essentially, arthritis is all about joint inflammation. In osteoarthritis, the protective cartilage between bones wears down over time, causing discomfort, swelling, and stiffness. In rheumatoid arthritis, the immune system targets the joint capsule's lining, a sturdy membrane enclosing all the joint components. This casing becomes inflamed and swollen, eventually causing harm to the cartilage and bone within the joint. Now that we understand the basics of arthritis, let's shift our focus to how our diet can play a crucial role in managing its symptoms. What we consume significantly shapes our overall health. Research has shown that the right diet can make a substantial difference, aiding in holistic healing. Today, we're going to explore not just what foods to avoid, but also what foods we should include if we have arthritis. Let's start by discussing the 7 worst foods for arthritis. 1. Added sugars. All right, let's start with those tricky added sugars. You've probably heard of them. Sugars and syrups added to foods and drinks during their creation. These sugars are different from the natural ones found in fruits, veggies, and dairy. Imagine the sugars in your soft drinks, candies, baked goods, and many processed foods. They're like stealth agents, sneaking into our bodies and causing trouble. Too much of these sugars can lead to inflammation, which is our body's way of reacting to harm. But excessive inflammation can turn against us, aggravating arthritis pain. To make matters worse, these sugary delights are often loaded with calories, paving the way for weight gain. And extra weight means added pressure on our joints, especially in our legs, hips, and spine, cranking up the discomfort. 2. High salt foods. Now let's talk about salt, that trusty friend in the kitchen. We use it to amp up the flavors in our meals and keep our dishes fresh. But too much of a good thing can be bad, especially for arthritis. High salt foods can trigger inflammation in our bodies, adding to the pain and stiffness already present in arthritis. This inflammation can be a real pain for those joints. Moreover, excessive salt can upset our calcium balance, a vital element for maintaining strong bones and keeping joint problems at bay. Not to forget, too much salt can ramp up our blood pressure, adding more stress to our joints and worsening the pain. 3. Nightshades. Ah, the mysterious nightshades. These are a group of plants that some suspect might not be best buddies with arthritis, especially the inflammatory kind. We're talking about tomatoes, potatoes, eggplants, and peppers. Some folks believe they contain compounds called alkaloids that could stir up inflammation and joint discomfort in certain individuals. However, this isn't proven for everyone, so it's like a mystery we're still unraveling. 4. Alcohol. Next up, let's address the elephant in the room, alcohol. Excessive alcohol consumption can rev up inflammation in our bodies, making arthritis pain worse. It can also leave us parched and dehydrated. Not a good scenario for our joints. If we're taking medications to manage arthritis, alcohol might throw a spanner in the works, affecting how well these medications function. On top of that, alcohol can be a calorie heavyweight, potentially leading to weight gain. And you guessed it, more weight means more pressure on those joints. 5. Foods high in purines. Understanding the enemy is crucial. And in this case, we're talking about foods high in purines. Purines as little troublemakers that, when broken down during digestion, transform into uric acid. Now, uric acid itself is not harmful, and in fact, it's a natural byproduct of the body's metabolism. The problem arises when there's an excess of uric acid due to overconsumption of high purine foods. Uric acid is typically filtered through the kidneys and expelled via urine. However, an overabundance of uric acid can lead to the formation of uric crystals in the joints, sparking a painful inflammatory response known as gout. These needle-like crystals irritate the joints, causing intense pain, swelling, and redness. Gout most commonly affects the big toe, knees, ankles, and elbows. Futai and purines encompass a range of items, including organ meats like liver, specific seafood such as anchovies and sardines, and certain vegetables like spinach and asparagus. While vegetables have a lower purine content compared to meats and seafood, it's prudent for individuals with arthritis or those prone to gout to regulate their intake. It's about not just managing the symptoms, but also proactively adjusting our diets to lead a life with less pain and inflammation. 6. Grilled meat and its effects on arthritis. Grilling meat can create compounds known as advanced glycation end products, AGEs. When we eat this grilled meat, these compounds enter our bodies. Similarly, fried foods like French fries and chicken nuggets also contain high levels of AGEs due to the frying process. Even processed foods like cookies, cakes, and sugary snacks can lead to increased AGE formation in our bodies. For folks dealing with arthritis, these AGEs can cause problems. They contribute to heightened stiffness and pain in our joints. To counter these effects, it's a good idea to limit these types of foods in our diet. 7. Red meat and its connection to arthritis. Arthritis often involves inflammation, where our body's immune system mistakenly attacks its own tissues, causing pain and swelling. Red meat contains substances like arachidonic acid, a precursor to molecules that promote inflammation called prostaglandins. Consuming red meat can increase arachidonic acid levels, potentially intensifying the inflammatory reactions associated with arthritis. Red meat is also rich in omega-6 fatty acids, which are essential but need to be balanced with omega-3 fatty acids. An imbalance between these fatty acids can trigger inflammation. Consuming excessive red meat can disrupt this healthy balance, possibly worsening inflammation related to arthritis. Now let's shift our focus to the foods that can be our allies in battling arthritis and reducing inflammation. 1. Anti-inflammatory fats. Anti-inflammatory fats are like the unsung heroes of a healthy diet, particularly for individuals dealing with arthritis. These fats, often referred to as good fats, possess remarkable properties that can help combat inflammation, a common denominator in arthritis pain. Monounsaturated fats. These are a type of anti-inflammatory fat found in foods like olive oil, avocados, and nuts. They have been associated with reducing levels of C-reactive protein, CRP, a marker of inflammation in the body. Omega-3 fatty acids. A subset of polyunsaturated fats, omega-3 fatty acids are renowned for their potent anti-inflammatory effects. They can be found in abundance in fatty fish like salmon, mackerel, and sardines. These fatty acids help dampen the inflammatory response in the body and have been linked to reduced arthritis symptoms. Omega-9 fatty acids. Another type of monounsaturated fat, omega-9s, can be found in olive oil, avocados, and nuts. While not as famous as omega-3s, they also contribute to an anti-inflammatory diet. By incorporating these healthy fats into our meals, we can proactively manage inflammation and potentially ease arthritis symptoms. Replacing saturated and trans fats, found in fried and processed foods, with these anti-inflammatory fats is a dietary step in the right direction. 2. Fishy fats. Fishy fats, particularly omega-3 fatty acids, are like magical elixirs for anyone dealing with arthritis. These special fats have incredible anti-inflammatory properties, making them a must-have in an arthritis-friendly diet. Eicosapentaenoic acid, EPA, and docosahexaenoic acid, DHA. These are the two primary types of omega-3 fatty acids found in oily fish like salmon, sardines, trout, and mackerel. EPA and DHA play a crucial role in reducing inflammation in the body and can help alleviate arthritis symptoms. Alpha-linolenic acid, ALA. While EPA and DHA are found in marine sources, ALA is a type of omega-3 fatty acid found in plant-based sources like flax seeds, chia seeds, and walnuts. While ALA is not as potent as EPA and DHA, it still contributes to the overall anti-inflammatory effects of omega-3. 3. Fruits and vegetables. Plant-based foods like fruits and veggies are your friendly neighborhood superheroes. They fight inflammation in your body and help you steer clear of things that might worsen your arthritis. Some fruits and veggies that are especially great for arthritis include onions, garlic, leeks, and ginger. Thanks to a special ingredient called quercetin, which fights inflammation. Voila! That's a wrap for today's video. Crafting top-notch content requires diligent research, time, and a whole lot of effort to ensure it's a goldmine of value for all you fantastic viewers out there. Now, here's a tiny favor to ask. It'll only take a swift 2 seconds of your time. Smash that subscribe button and ring that bell icon to join our amazing community. If you uncovered a nugget of wisdom in this video, a thumbs up and a share with your nearest and dearest would mean the world to us. Let's spread the knowledge and make a difference. And of course, your thoughts matter immensely. Drop us a comment down below. We're all ears and excited to hear from you.